So we have the world in front of us, and there are problems. We have clearly identified what they are. We know what needs to be done. Now we need to do it. Getting people to not use plastic bags requires generative efforts. It requires everybody pulling together all at the same time. You cannot create these kinds of change without the full force of the struggle. The new generations, who it is absolutely critical for you to remember that if you cut down all your trees and you pollute all your water and you destroy all your wildlife and you pollute your planet and you keep building nuclear reactors that are going to explode and create 600-year volcanoes that spew toxic fucking chemicals into the atmosphere and destroy billions and billions of acres of ecosystems until all of you are living in nothing but your own filth and war and famine and terror and just fear and hell on earth. Right? You can fix this. You can fix this. You can't do it if you just completely throw religion out. People who are calling for the end of religion are crazy wackos, man. What are they gonna do? Murder everyone who believes? That's a solution to them. There's 8 billion people on the planet, folks, and that number is not abating. People are gonna have to die, no doubt. But they're gonna do that anyway. You don't have to kill anyone. You don't have to save anyone. Just let things be. This is the wisdom of the spiritual mystery. This is the wisdom of all of it. Now all science and mysticism is converging on consciousness. Everyone knows it. There's no arguments. You can clearly look back through the history of the world, all of our texts. All of the books, you can look at all of them. If you read the oldest ones, you can see what people are going to say in the future. People just recreate the same stories. If you know the basic story, then you know. You don't need a new story. You don't, any story is a good story. All stories are the same story. There's only one story. It's us. It's all of us. It's Earth. It's planet Earth. It doesn't matter if you write them down or tell them to your kids up fire. It doesn't matter if you upload everything onto a digital web of information that exists in nothing. Well, it actually exists in these physical boards that are in buildings and plugged into walls that are being fed by electricity, but it doesn't matter. That's all organic. It's just like a human body. Everything that you've created, your road system, your vehicles, your cars, you look at a freeway, red cells, white cells, traveling up and down the tube, filtering off the big tube to the little tube to deposit all of their little ingredients all along the skin of the flesh of the earth. It's all organic, people. The cities are just as organic as the forests, but you can't, you don't get rid of the forest for the city. Have cities and have forests. They're both good. You don't have to choose between them. You have to know when to stop. This is anthropology. This is science. This is knowing how to manage culture. I have just gone through the program by the Cultural Resource Management Masters who think they know everything. And they don't know shit. It's the worst program ever. Because they're all worried about what they get paid, and they're all worried about what they can say, what they can't say, what they're going to get in trouble for, what somebody's going to get in trouble for. Everybody's so scared, so frightened, so afraid. There's no freedom. No one is brave here. You're all cowards. All of you are cowards. I know. I look in your eyes every day. The only people in this world who are brave and alive are the people who aren't attached to this beast. Anthropology, you science, you can identify the beast. You've identified it and you've said we have to get off of it. We have to wean ourselves from the ditty of capitalism. We have to wean ourselves from mammon's breasts. We have to stop drinking the milk straight out of the fucking god's nuts every day, man. You guys, you've taken all of it. You've soaked up all the magic and taken all the good.